What is going on here?
This is called the Augmented Reality Sandbox. It was developed by someone out at UC Davis as a study tool for studying watersheds and teaching tool for teaching about contour lines, color topographical maps, water flow, things about basins and, you know, lakes and streams and dams and pretty much anything to do with watersheds. It was developed with a grant, therefore everything is open source. So they have lots of instructions online to where you can go on there and download the software and build your own.
And so you can dig in it and it changes?
That's correct. As the topo changes,
oh, wow,
you have a 3D camera mounted up here, an Xbox Kinect 3D camera. And it reads the...
the water's actually running down.
Right.
That's pretty cool.
So it all follows a formula or a code that makes it a natural flow, and you can adjust all the parameters of it. So if you displace all that water with my hand, it should create like a little wave. The wave will go out, and then it'll come back.
Oh, wow.
Takes quite a bit of calculations to do the water flow and everything, so you got to have pretty current hardware.
I bet.
Make it rain.
And you can even see how slow it's moving at the moment due to the amount of water that's on there. So I can drain all the water out. I don't know if it's going to pick that up because it's the new version.
Okay.
Okay.
It wants fingers. So it detects the fingers to produce.
So each finger is a cloud.
Oh, I see.
So I can make it rain.
Huh.
And then watch the water flow.
So your hand is the cloud there.
Right.
And then it...
Originally they had it where just if you were at a certain height, it would start raining, but then it detected everything as a cloud, so it was just rain.
Wow.
And the more water there is, the more heavy calculations it has to do, along with the topo, you know, and all of that. That's also calculations. And there have been other people that have taken this concept and done more artistic things with it, just having fun with the software and developing other ways of adding a sound element to it or in a completely
non-educational
manner. It's
right.
More just fun interactivity, you know.
Wow.
And you can adjust all the parameters in the software and change the colors and make them look like different areas. You can make the water look like lava.
You kind of can't help but
it's mesmerizing.
Play in it.
Yep.
Yeah, how'd you guys get any work done?
I mean, this is work.
That's
this
right, yeah, I know. Isn't that the awesome thing about this kind of job? This is work.
I had seen these online and thought it'd be fun to build one or play with one.
Okay.
You know, seen them at educational centers, like discovery centers and things like that around the country. It just seemed like a really good project for the space to utilize different elements of the space, like the workshop to build the cabinet and, you know, just the technology and computers and things like that, put them together just to fiddle with it. And then just to use it as a marketing tool, basically. But it turned into more of a, I've already got other schools and stuff that are interested in town here.
I bet.
They all want it to show up and for the art classes and the science classes, a lot of the art. You know, a lot of the teachers, now it's getting a little brighter. The schools are wanting more science and math in their art program, trying to figure out how to ways of like teach kids.
Well, I can see that. I remember like my eighth grade earth science class, they had the analog version of this where they hooked a hose up to a sandbox and you could watch like rivers form and change as you block stuff off. And I thought it was really cool. This actually sort of reminds me of that, but way more.
Yeah, this
and it doesn't involve water hose.
With the waves and a lot of people get, I mean, after a while you actually think you're looking at water.
Yeah, you do.
You
really do.